welcome to the Elimination Season 4, Round 2. Here to entertain you is Pauline, Dave, and of course, your host, Bob! Oh, Mark calling us. Come in.
Here we are once again for elimination time. I'm Bob, your host. Hold on, let me turn my headphones off. I can't hear myself. Oh, there we go. Yeah. I'm Bob, your host of Elimination, the podcast that brings you no brain cells, no education, and no sense whatsoever. Here with my dad, Dave.
Hello.
And cousin Pauline. Hello. He's got a cup of tea. Dave's got a coffee.
Always got a cup of tea.
Dave's got a coffee. You got a saccharine in there,
Why
Dave?
Why did you say coffee?
I always have coffee.
He always has a coffee.
I never had tea.
He never has tea.
Holy parrot.
Right, okay, we're going to start a bit different today.
Oh.
Oh, what's going on?
Well, I got a message.
You called me right out,
I got a message from a fan.
Well,
what, a fan of yours or a fan of his?
No, a fan of Dolly Jamlet. No, no, he is a fan of the podcast.
He's mental.
Oh, he is mental.
Do we know him? Is he a family
No,
member?
You don't know him. He's a random person. I don't know him. You don't know him.
You don't know him from Adam?
His name's Phil.
You don't know him?
I don't know him. He just messaged
me. Oh, he really
me.
Is just yeah. a random.
He's out of the blue.
He's just a random. That's nice
That's
of us
not,
to say.
No, I didn't think
that sounded. He said, hi, Bob. That's it. Oh. Hi, Bob. I'll try and keep this short. He doesn't. I came across Elimination Podcast because I work nights at...
Leave that out.
Yeah, a store that, you know, sounds like a forest. A big forest.
With a river.
Warehouse. So I like listening to stand-ups while I work. And two of my favourites are Lee Evans and Peter Kay. So when I saw your heavyweight bout. In season 4, round 1, I thought, what's this? He thought. Gave it a listen and enjoyed it. Then went back to season 1 and binged it right up to now.
Oh, my God.
What I'll say is how strange it sounds listening to you guys talk about COVID and social distancing. I think the different one should have won season 1. And season 2 should have been this or this. I'm not going to say because somebody might pick up this episode. Go back and listen to them. Although I think Matrix should have gone further. Can't believe Dave knocked out Forrest Gump.
Oh,
I totally agree.
Too.
That was commitments, wasn't it?
Phil, I don't know, Phil.
I think it was the commitments.
Yeah, I think it was. Yeah. Horrified.
I ain't got the tune anymore, but he's got to get it off my chest.
Oh, come on.
Phil, yeah.
Get it off your chest. shall I read it to you? Or should we save it? Annoys me. My wife and kids never recycle rubbish because our black bin gets so full. I have to keep jumping on it and do dump runs to get rid of it.
He would hate me then because I don't recycle either.
I don't believe in it, but I do believe in a good old dump run. I do like a dump run.
Are we talking?
No, I don't find it depressing.
Oh, I like going to the tip. Dump. I just can't reverse in the space. I panic. I do it every time and I'm fine, but I panic beforehand.
Sorry, love, you can't park there. This is for cardboard. and he's put on here, he's put something else, but I'm going to ignore it because we'll talk about it later. And he says...
Oh,
and
is it bad then?
No, it's good. And lastly, did Dave go to the 1978 FA Cup final? Osborne 1-0. Winky face.
I did. I went there with Cousin Jeff, funny enough.
Oh, Cousin Jeff. Did you see Phil there?
I might have done. Might be standing next to him for all I know. it weren't the great cup final for Arsenal. They was well beaten that day. Just didn't have a good team at the time.
Got to the final, though.
But if he's interested in Ipswich, in my Back of the Day podcast, I do an actual whole show on Ipswich 1961-62 season, and I'm going to do one on Ipswich 80-81 when they finished runners-up. And they were probably the best team never to win the league. They were a great team, Mariner, Brazil and all that crowd. So get yourself in there, Phil.
Yeah.
That was nice of him, though.
Yeah, thanks, Phil, for getting in touch. I hope your night shift goes well, and... Yeah, it's depressing. Night shifts are depressing,
aren't
they?
I've done 15 years of nights. Loved it. Well, I did at the time, yeah.
Oh, no, I couldn't.
I've done nights for one summer from about May to September. Oh, I quite enjoyed it.
I did radiographer's assistant And I used to sort of go to these sites, and it was places where nobody ever goes. So you would go to this place where it's just a ton of pipes. Nobody's ever walked down there, so there's cobwebs and shh all over it.
Shh.
Yeah, all over it.
Cobwebs and shit.
Yeah, well, language, Timothy. And then we'd have to sort of, I'd have to put a rope out so nobody came down. It's night, nobody's there. I've put a rope out, put these little signs on it saying don't come around this bit. Nobody's there working whatsoever.
Yeah, but you can guarantee if you didn't put that sign out, somebody would come.
Yeah, right, definitely. One of the best one for that was we did Heathrow Airport when they did, is it Terminal 5, the new one, the newest one? And we were literally in a hole on a runway, sectioned off, and planes were going past. The wing was going over our heads. It was something that you never...
I think you might have exaggerated.
No, I'm serious. There was a fence, and the plane, they put the fence up just to guard us. But we were on the runway. It was crazy. And what they did, they had this hole and a pipe visible, and then people would go in, weld it, and then we'd come in and test it. And if it was still cracks, then they'd have to go away, they'd weld it again. And we did that. Yeah. We did that all night for about... hours, until it was right, and then they filled the hole back in, and we was allowed to go home. That was one of the longest days of my life.
Oh, you didn't enjoy it at all?
No, not at all. Oh. But the engine's going past every now and again.
It's quite good seeing all the planes.
When we first arrived, because you have to, the isotope, we call, in the industry, we call it a bomb. It's a bomb because it's radioactive.
Dangerous things.
Definitely. And, but they said, that's what we called it every day. Did you pick up the bomb? Did you get the bomb? Yeah. So when you go into the airport, we went to security. He said, do not say the word bomb. He said, because if you say that, all the shutters come down, alarms and all that kind of stuff, and we have to wait months to come back. Do say isotope. Just say that word. Don't say the word
bomb.
Oh,
and the minute you're told not to do something, that's all you can do.
And I just didn't talk. So you had to go through. You had to have the passport with you, even though you're not going anywhere. You had to have everything with paperwork. It was crazy.
Do you know what? I'd never get bored of watching a plane take off.
Watching a plane
take off? Yeah, but you know when you see, for real, when you're at the airport or whatever, and you see planes taking off, I still think, oh, all these years later.
It is amazing.
It just doesn't make sense. I never get bored of that. It doesn't make sense, does it?
Wifey has to hold my hand when the plane takes off. She practically draws blood.
Whoever I'm with next, I have to hold their hand.
We don't pay the extra to sit next to each other, but we always do. It's just flagging money out, isn't it? But one time we didn't, and we was across the aisle.
No,
so we had to hold hands across the aisle. I felt a right burk.
Everyone was looking.
The thing is, if it's going to happen, it's going to happen, isn't it? You've got no control.
Yeah, just assume the position. It just means you die in that position rather than sitting up straight, doesn't it, really?
Yeah, I just don't. I don't. I see it as a. I can't think about how high up I am. I just think about it as like a simulator. That's how I sort of think. You get in this tube, and then. Hours later, you get off.
Yeah,
that's
can't comprehend that you're actually in the air. I don't mind the flying bits, take off and land a con.
When the heels.
It's funny when you sit at the back of the plane, because when you take off, it's like you're going up in sort of stages.
Yeah, and
it's
sort of like this as well sometimes.
And going from the sort of the ground, you're seeing the ground and the grass next to the runway, and then all of a sudden it's just fields and just.
Yeah.
That, I can't get my head around it.
In my mind, I'm like, if we're going to crash now, not now. Get to a certain height.
We might survive. We definitely won't. Yeah. I like looking out the window, though, when you go above the clouds.
The whole thing just scared.
The first time that ever happened, when I went to Valaraki, and we went above the clouds, all my mates had been abroad before, so it was nothing to them. And I was looking out the window, and it was just, I couldn't comprehend it. Yeah. I was like, wow.
But I've got worse as I've got older with flying. When I was younger, it didn't really bother me. But as I'm older,
I suppose you know what goes into it. When you're a kid, it's like fascinating, isn't it? It's like
if I didn't go as a kid, Mum wouldn't fly. And to get Mum to go to Florida, because she just wouldn't fly.
She's like Mr. T. Yeah.
She flew when she was younger,
but then that was it. She just weren't going to, that was it, not flying again. All their holidays, all our holidays, caravans, Cornwall, stuff like that. And then... Dad really wanted to go to Florida. We all said we were going to go. So my ex-husband, his mum and dad, Lewis, Chris and Susie, Charlotte, we're all going.
Did you get invited, Dave?
We're all going. And so we said to mum and dad was like, I really, really want to go. You know, the rides, because at that age, dad loved rides.
Yeah.
Florida, he just really wanted to go. And mum was, well, I can't go. I can't, I'm not doing an 8-hour flight. There's no way.
I ain't got no plane.
So drink this milk, mum.
I said to dad, on the quiet, would you come without mum? And he, no, I ain't doing that, which he would never in a million years. So I said, well, we'll pretend that you will. And he's like, she knows I wouldn't go without her. I said, just see. So
pretend.
And I'm like, oh, mum, you're going to miss that. So dad went, look, he said, if I'm still going to go no matter what. Should have seen the look. He said, that's how badly I want to go, that I'm going to go. No, you
don't
go
take this away from me.
Yeah, and I said, Mum, Dad wants to go so desperately. Surely you could do that for him. And she thought about it. A couple of days later, she said, what I've been thinking is, she said, if the plane's going to go down and you've all gone, you're all going to die and I'm on my own.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, this is what she said. You know what, Mum, like, I'm at home on my own anyway, so I might as well go down with you all. If we're all going to die, we'll all go together.
I mean, together.
That was her way.
I mean, I get the logic, but yeah. Wow, that's...
But then once it was booked and everything, she was more excited than what we were. Apart from at the airport, you couldn't talk. She was so frightened. She cried on the plane. So she, not boo-hoo for everyone to notice, but she was sitting in her seat and the air hostess come over to her because she could see. Mum was red in the face. Like, she was so, so scared. Tears coming down. And the air hostess sat with her for a little while, talked to her for a little while. But once we were up there, she was fine. It was the whole takeoff.
Yeah.
And then she loved it when she was out there, didn't she?
Oh, of course. Yeah. Anybody would. Yeah.
Strangest flight I ever had was when we went to see her half-sister in Arizona. And we stopped off at, I think it was Cleveland. And the plane we got from there, the hopper, from... It only had two seats one side and one the other.
No, I saw that.
It was like a cigar tube. It was bizarre.
I've been in a, when I went to the Maldives, we got in like an Indiana Jones style, rattly, one seat either side.
I always feel bizarre. Better. The bigger the plane, the safer I am. The littler the plane, the more
I am. Well, I mean, this was, it was rattling. It was, and what was bizarre about it is that you look down, it's just ocean. Like, there was no... We couldn't see any land whatsoever. And then it was a seaplane. So it landed and there was like a pallet just floating.
Oh, no.
And they said, yeah, just wait here. The boat will come and get you. So we sat down on this pallet. It was just a wooden thing with our cases. The plane took off and we was just there. And the boat came out and got us. And we got on the boat and it took us into shore. But that... It was just bizarre.
I'll tell you something else about that flight. There was, you know, when you go from Gatwick and you get on the plane, go, this is Pilot Barrington Smythe here. We'll be travelling at 30. So, and you think, oh, yeah,
he's all right.
This bloke here goes, ha, I'm Billy Joe. I'll be your pilot today. He goes, hey, we're in for some bad weather. It's going to be a hell of a ride. Strap yourselves in.
Oh, my God.
Strap yourself in, it's going to be a hell of a ride. And we have this little cigar tube,
I'd be crying at that point.
With this one stewardess woman, got up there with a basket, which says, anybody want a sandwich? It was a sandwich, it was like a roll, like a baguette type thing. So I thought, yeah, I'll have one of them.
Subway.
And then when we were coming into land, lightning and everything. It's fantastic. She was absolutely, she was crapping herself. I found it quite amusing, really, watching her, you know.
I just watch film after film when I'm on
a plane. I can't.
I watched Gran Torino.
All right, okay. I was watching The Shape of Water.
That's a strange film.
Yeah, wasn't it just? I was watching it on a plane and all of a sudden...
I like that bird in it, though. What's her name? Oh,
I've no idea. I didn't finish watching it because it was very sexual and I was watching it on a plane. I kept looking over my shoulder like I was watching some kind of X-rated movie. Yeah.
I can't concentrate. I will listen to music or I watch the map.
Oh, God. Oh. I can't watch the map.
He never moves, does he?
I keep going back to the map.
Takes 3 weeks to get up the new goal, so we can turn left.
No, I love it. I just watch films, so I can't wait to...
Oh, sure, I've watched film. Watch The Watchmen. Goes on about 3.5 hours. That was a good one.
I remember I was on a plane. I don't know where I was going, but we was on the plane, and it was everyone was asleep. All the things were shut.
How can people sleep? I don't get easy. That.
I can't sleep when I'm
lazy. No, I can't.
Well, you know, I'm snoring. I'm very popular.
And I was just watching film after film after film. I was loving it. I was absolutely
living the dream.
Yeah. And the woman kept coming over, the stewardess, saying, hey, do you want another drink? Would you like, yeah, yeah, yeah. Do you want some pretzels? Yeah, yeah, I'll take that, I'll take it. And then I think I was with Vicky going to Florida, and she sort of woke up, and I had a big pile of cups, empty cups, all empty. I think I actually watched all 3 Lord of the Rings. Like, not all of them. I think I got halfway through the last one or something. But I was gutted because I wanted to watch the whole lot, yeah.
When we went to New York, I tried to watch Aladdin, the one with, you know, Will Smith.
Oh, no. God.
I tried to watch it, but you know when you can't concentrate in every little...
Oh, I thought it's because it was so shit.
No! Yeah.
But that scared me, that New York flight, because you saying about the pilot... He did say, I mean, it sounded posh and all that, so I was happy. But
have you looked down yet?
He did tell us it was going to be very smooth, like the weather condition were good. He said, but the last 40 minutes might be a bit bumpy. So I spent 8 hours waiting for the last 40 minutes. And it was just a few little, but nothing bad at all. But he shouldn't have said that. Why say that?
Yeah, it's so unnecessary. I can't wait for the light to come on. Boom. Right, TV. Boom. Go. What can I watch? What can I do? Yeah. And go.
And I hate going to the toilet, don't you?
You know what? For the first...
Flush it when you're
probably
back.
Probably...
Wash your hands. Back to go.
Three or four flights I went on, I didn't leave my seat. I stayed in my seat the whole time. Because I don't know what it was. I thought that once when I got out of my seat, you know when you walk down a bus and it's all sort of, you sort of wandering about? And I thought it was going to be like that. So I just didn't want to get up. I've got a phone call, have we?
I haven't got a clue what that is.
Got a phone call.
Cranbrook, where's that?
Cranbrook's Kent, isn't it?
Don't know.
Oh, it's got to be something interesting. Do you want to answer it live?
I had a bloke in work. I wouldn't call him a mate. He was just a bloke in work. And he was so henpecked by his wife, and she was so dominated by her that their son married an American girl, and the wedding was in America, so they had to go over there. And on the way back... He was on the window seat, so she was on the inside. She was a big girl, apparently. She was a two-seat woman. And he was so, not frightened of her, but it was about a 13-hour flight. He didn't go to the toilet once because he didn't want to disturb her to get out. So Jesus, she was Spargo, so he just sat there with his legs crossed for
30 hours. You can do that for 30 hours.
I didn't want to disturb her, he said.
We're quite lucky, really, because, not lucky, I mean, Vic's got arthritis, so she gets like not a disabled thing, but they give you extra leg room. You know, the ones that are in front of, like, where they keep all the food?
Yeah.
So you get extra leg room, and they come and get you first. So
that's nice.
They come and get you, so I have to carry all the bags and that. And then we get extra leg room, and we get on the plane first as well.
Oh,
so
nice.
Yeah, and when you're there as well, if you're not behind another seat, obviously the screen it's in the headset, in the headrest. But if you've got that in front of you, it comes out of the arm, and it's boom there. So yeah,
nice.
Yeah, it works out well. Yeah, it does. And they do that she like checks in before we get there and all that. I don't understand all of that. Her and her dad love it. Like they check in on an app
before they actually get there.
I don't understand.
I'll have to ask her about that because we've gone to Spain in about.
But you're checking
just
in,
don't remember.
But you're not there. Like how? I don't get it.
I've not done that.
But she is, as soon as we get in the cab, she is on the way to the airport. She is bursting. Like she's so excited. She's so.
I'm always excited, especially if you go to bloody Florida.
Until I get there, I'm like, I hate traveling.
I like the journey. The journey home's a pain in the arse.
Especially your last one.
Yeah.
The journey home is awful, but the going is exciting. No.
Oh, we're only going to Spain, so it'd be only be a couple of hours or something.
Yeah.
I just, I hate the whole packing and moving.
Carla did the packing. She does all the packing.
Her mum and dad actually saw me getting a bit flustered because the day we came back from Florida, they were staying on for like another week. They were going to Vegas or somewhere. And so we're packing our bags in our room. It's stifling hot. Like, it's so hot there. I can't handle it. I just don't do well in any kind of heat in the UK, let alone in Florida. I'm sweating, right? And mum came and knocked on the door and said, oh, can you just put some of our stuff in your bag, stuff that we've bought and that we don't need? I was like, yeah, sure, that's fine. So we went into their room. And I'm not joking, and I've said this many times, they had so much... It's like garden stuff, like little metal bikes and plant pots with like fake plants. Yeah, and they're like, if you take that, and then we don't have to carry it to Vegas and then bring it home. And I'm like, we have to sit on our cases anyway to get them shut. Like, and I'm trying to be the kind of
the nice guy,
son-in-law kind of But I didn't lose it, but I was really sort of like. Well, how are we going to get out in there? Like, I couldn't hold it back anymore. It was so hot and so, oh man. But we did do it. We got some stuff in the thing and they were really grateful. And then I found out that two of their cases were actually empty because when they go to Vegas, they buy a load of other stuff. So they take empty cases.
I've heard of people doing that.
They do that all the time. So, but the good thing, I mean, they're so sweet. They're such lovely people. They send me pictures. They don't know what they're looking for because I say that the wrestling figures that I collect, they're out in the States more than they are in the UK. So when they go to any kind of Target, Walmart, or anything like that, they take photos of the shelves and send them to me. Obviously, I'm in bed at that time, so they leave the shop, and then I say, oh, no, they're not the ones or whatever. I never feel, even if they are, I feel bad, like, saying, yeah, get that one. I don't want, you know.
Oh, it's nice that they think
They don't. She calls them little men. Oh, we saw little men.
Better dolls.
Yeah. Oh, we saw little men in the... So... It's so lovely, but that moment I totally lost it. Like I couldn't.
I'd love
it.
To see that.
Yeah, it was. But as I mentioned before, with the tire on the car, that was the worst moment, and I rescued it. So we're good. They're out there now. My mum and dad are out there now. Nice. Yeah, they're out there for. I think they're out there.
What,
for
Florida or Vegas?
Florida for like a month and a half now. So yeah. Yeah, living the dream.
They said
they're going to get to the point where they're not going to be able to do it anymore. And they love it. You know, they're getting on a bit.
Would they not just move out there, do you think?
I don't think they would, just because of, like, family and nieces and nephews, grandkids. And all that kind of stuff. I don't think they would, but I think her dad would. Her mum, not so much, I think. She thinks she gets homesick after a while.
Yeah. Oh, Vic would miss them, wouldn't she?
Oh, yeah. We all would. Her mum's such a character. She's crazy.
Oh, she's hilarious.
But we love her.
She's
crazy. Yeah, but we love her for it, yeah. The draw. 25 minutes in.
Katherine Ryan versus Tommy Cooper.
I'm ready to vote. I honestly haven't seen that much of Katherine Ryan, just on Taskmaster.
What was the name of the bloke? The songs you know.
Oh, that's Peter Hudson.
Oh, yeah, Peter Hudson.
You trust him.
Yeah.
That was great.
That's the finest moment. Yeah, it was good. But she was good with Louis Theroux as well when you saw her, like not being a comedian, just being her. Yeah.
Well, she was the same on there. Who do you think you are? She was herself. And she
just seems really nice. Yeah, just seems like a really nice person. Tommy Cooper, in comparison. Awesome. But... A funny arsehole.
Yeah, I didn't know he was an arsehole
until
you...
Well, I don't think this arsehole thing. I mean, he had another woman. I mean, bloody hell. He wouldn't be the only... he wouldn't be the only bloke in show business to have another woman, would he? Yeah. I mean, come on.
Just naturally. I mean, and timeless as well, I think. Because his act isn't to do with kind of people and impressions or anything like that. It's... just funny. It's just silly, funny.
Just bone jar.
Yeah. pull the string. Yeah, he is timeless. And it's almost like that dad joke thing, isn't it? That now is kind of getting to become dad jokes. Yeah. Kind of, but back then it was just that was him.
It was just funny.
And it wasn't racial. It wasn't prejudiced. None of those things.
It's just stupid.
Nothing applies to him. But they'll probably find something in the future.
Oh, of course they will. The Feds. Yeah, the Feds will be racist in some way.
Spoons and jars. Some fear the way that spoon damaged that jar.
He didn't actually talk like that, so the people that really do talk like that, we're offended.
all the Moroccan Turkish people with that hat on, he's obviously abusing them, I mean.
Oh, don't.
It'll happen.
Let's hope he never gets that bad.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Speech.
Let's do a question, Bob.
Oh, go on then. Question time.
Should I do one?
Yeah. No!
What?
It's always Pauline who gets the glory.
Is that because he's next to me?
Next to me.
Keep on doing what you do. You're going to get next to me. Oh, look, who wraps it up like that?
Oh, for God's sake.
He's on fingers and thumbs, isn't he? We've done this one because Pauline couldn't say the word, innit?
What was the word?
Anyway, and we've done a skionce. Oh, but two.
Was it Hock Hogan?
Yeah. Oh, look, they blanked that one.
Oh, for
God's
sake.
That one. Thank you, Robert.
What's that in there for?
What's going on?
Blank question.
We'll keep them in there. We use them to write new ones on.
Yeah, but you said that last time. You're going to pick them out, aren't you?
I've got the same one.
What?
If you're taking part in a skionce. I'm serious.
It's going well.
Yeah, I'll do that one.
Oh,
that's
cool.
A big one.
Bernie, this is a long-running saga. Oh.
Oh.
What is your favourite Elvis song?
Oh.
You must like some Elvis songs. I know what mine is.
What's that?
Don't be cruel.
Don't be cruel
to my heart is true. I don't want no other lover.
Yeah, that's...
Maybe it's a dream. Sing it on.
That was pretty good, I like that.
I
do like a little less conversation,
a little more action in me.
No!
All this aggravation and sadness. What about the one through you?
Oh, and actually. When you smile, yeah, I do love brighter. That's probably it.
Ooh. Ooh. What about Suspicious Minds?
No.
We can go. Oh, I'll tell you a really good one. I've forgotten it. I'll come back to you in a minute. The one the Pet Shop Boys done.
What?
Go west in your underpants. Go west.
Oh, Dave, think of it, because it'll bug me.
No, talk of other ones. I don't like Jailhouse Rock.
I don't like a lot of
them. I'll tell you one I do like. The Girl of My Best Friend.
How does that go?
The way she walks. The way she talks.
Yeah, I recognise that. I thought it was a bit.
How long can I... Oh, you must have heard that
one.
Yeah,
I've heard of that song, yeah. What's he doing?
He's playing Silly Buggers.
This is mine.
Where you looked?
Wise men say... That's a good impression, Bob.
I know, thank you. Suspicious Minds, Burning Love.
No, oh, well... Hunker,
no, definitely not.
Hunker. If I Can Dream...
No, I don't like that one.
Do you want me to read more? Heartbreak Hotel.
That was his big
Hound Dog.
You ain't that's a good one.
That's all right.
Guitar solo.
Love Me Tender.
That's too soppy. That's too slow.
Too much.
Quite boring.
What's too much?
I don't like the her.
I like Treat Me Like a Fool.
Treat me in a cruel. Oh, shook up.
Love me. Oh, yeah. Teddy Bear, that's another good one. He's made a lot of good songs.
Yeah.
Are You Lonesome Tonight?
What's the one I'm thinking of?
Can't Help Falling in Love.
It's good. A slow one. It's a
Good Luck Charm. She's Not You.
I don't like Good Luck Charm. That was. This is boring. Yeah, just at the army, Elvis. Good Luck Charm. And the worst song he ever done was Wooden Heart.
Do I know that?
She looks like an angel.
She did. Oh, do you know what song I absolutely hate with a passion?
Go on.
In the Ghetto.
Oh, me too.
I never cried.
Oh me my too. God. I used to work. I've said this a million times before, but I'm sure to say it again. I used to work in like a engineering place that made rotors, and it was all old ladies, right? There's loads of old ladies, and they used to play Smooth FM, And this used to come on about 10 times every hour.
There's a worse one than that.
And they'd always forget that it'd just been on. And they'd all turn to go, oh.
I don't mind it, actually.
Like, it's just been on. You've heard it. Oh,
crying in the chapel's a worse one.
Oh, I don't know that one. Oh, God. Crying in the chapel.
We were crying in the chapel.
Oh, no, I don't think I do recognise it.
This reminds me of Ocean's 11. And that dance game that we did.
The thing is, this song, that could have been sort of made in that. It don't sound old, does it? It sounds like it could have been made.
Yeah, it's like a dance track. Out. Yeah, Unchained Melody.
No, oh, I know what song it is. I know what I'm thinking of. You were always on my mind.
Oh, I don't like
that's
that
a great
song.
Wow, that's a good song.
No.
Viva Las Vegas. ZZ Top do a good version of that.
Yeah, that's it. That's all the Elvis songs.
The one I like is the one you said.
What?
Well, I forgot my one.
Oh, my God.
I said, yeah, really like, I do actually really like that one.
Yeah.
Don't be cool.
It's a hell dog, yeah.
I do hate the fact that he's kind of gone to the point where everyone can do a rubbish impression of him.
I can't.
No, but you know that voice?
I don't see how I rock and roll.
Yeah. Well, this is lovely.
He can't help but that's his voice, though, can he?
He is one of the all-time great performers, though, isn't he? Without a shadow of a doubt.
I don't know what it is about him. He just makes me cringe.
Is it the fat version?
Slimy,
the fat version. The burger. He loved the burger. He did love a burger.
In later life, he did.
He did love a burger. I mean, that. If you're on Spotify, I'm just going to show Pauline the top picture of Elvis. I mean, that is a good-looking guy, isn't it?
All I see is his daughter when I look at that. I mean, he's obviously good looking.
Elvis
then.
Presley. What was his middle name?
Don't know.
Bob.
Aaron. Aaron, I think. Wasn't it?
Was it?
Was it? Sure, it was.
Elvis Aaron. Born, love the name Aaron. I wanted that for Lewis.
Topelo, 1935.
That was sad about Lisa Marie, wasn't it?
That's a big con, isn't it? That Graceland thing. Jesus.
And of course, Forrest Gump taught him how to dance.
So. He did, yeah. He'd be nothing without Gump.
And you voted him out.
Yeah, well done, Dave, if that is your real name.
Phil weren't happy.
Yeah, Phil wasn't happy. Talking of Phil, I've got a little.
Little what?
A little. Talking of Phil, I've got a little. Well, this
is Phil's voice.
It is.
Oh my God.
We're going to hear from Phil.
Hooks.
He didn't know him.
I gave him my number. I said, he sent me a picture of his penis. No, he didn't.
Oh, is he going to...
He is.
Talk like that, like, because he's from there.
How do we know
he's from there? Well, he's Salt Zipswee, still. He's one of the tractor boys, isn't he? I bet he's got a straw in his mouth when he says this.
He does.
Sorry, Phil.
He does mention his work. So if he mentions it, it's fine. Okay?
Okay.
Right, okay, let's get this ready.
Hi, Bob. It's Amazon Phil here. I'll tell you something.
That's his nickname, Amazon Phil.
Right, okay.
Okay. Let me turn it up a bit. Hold on. Oh, yeah, it's up. Okay, ready?
Hi, Bob. It's Amazon Phil here. I'll tell you something that don't impress me much, and that is your brother, Michael. Sorry, I don't want to be too critical. I know he's your brother, and I love the show. But replacing him with Pauline has been a massive, massive upgrade. I couldn't stand the fact he thinks Red Dwarf's better than The Office.
Thank you.
And it fills me with dread every time you say there's a special guest and, you know, it turns out to be Wifey or Freddy. And I just feel relieved after that. So, yeah.
There you go.
It's funny that Wifey's Wifey, isn't it?
Football manager.
No, there's an extra bit he sent me as well. But yeah, so he's saying that you, when we say there's
you
a guest.
You know him and you told
I don't
to
know him.
That.
I don't
cheer
know
me up.
Phil, Amazon Phil, I do not know him. I promise you.
Oh,
I do not know him.
I don't imagine people would think that. That's really nice.
Well, Amazon Phil does on his night shift.
You'll get loading. That's a load of shit. We want Mike back.
It's not much of a compliment just being better than Mike, is it? Really?
Well, it is, yeah.
But when he says, like, we say, oh, there's a guest, and we say it's Wifey or Freddy or
he's
whatever. Then he's like, oh, okay, that's good.
Or
it's not Mike.
Mike.
Yeah. Amazon Phil and Mike are going to come to blows. There's an extra little bit. This bit.
Thank you, Phil.
This is a little bit too much, I think. Well, see, he put it in context that people might understand, like a football manager. Okay, ready?
If I was his football manager, I'd let him rot in the reserves on the bench.
He's funny. He can help himself, can't he?
Thanks, Amazon Phil, new listener.
That's really nice.
Amazon Phil.
Not quite so nice for Mike.
We've been binged. We've been binged at Amazon.
Oh, but he's not having to listen to now, because we're not actually prolific these days,
aren't we?
We've
been on your hiatus.
Hiatus? We've been on a hiatus. Cheers, Amazon Phil.
That's really made me smile, that. I'm really pleased about that.
Amazon Phil.
Amazon Phil.
Because you know what it was like about when you asked me to do it. It's like, oh, my God, but Mike's so good. You can't replace Mike. How do you replace him?
Easy. Anyone.
Oh. That don't impress
me much. Welcome to the party, pal. That was it. Thank you, Amazon Phil.
We need some more of them.
Yeah, absolutely. If you're listening to this, get in touch.
Can they get in touch?
I mean, we haven't given the email address out for a long time. And
so they've only got to put it on Facebook or email, haven't they, you know, that they've got one.
Yeah, I mean, I'm happy to send you my number and, like, Amazon Phil. As long as you're not a mental head case, then I think we'll be all right. But then you're sending it to a head case anyway, so it marries up.
Oh, really? That's made my day.
Yeah, did you want to hear it again? Do you want me to send it to you so you can put it on the loop?
So
do you want to hear it again?
When I'm feeling fed up, I listen to that.
It does sound a bit tractory in one bit.
Tractory?
In one bit.
Does he?
I'll say, Wyn.
Hi, Bob. It's Amazon Phil here. I'll tell you something that don't impress me much, and that is your brother, Michael. Sorry, I don't want to be too critical. I know he's your brother. I love the show.
At this point, I'm thinking, go for it.
It's when he says Summit.
Sutton.
Yeah.
It's Amazon Phil here. I'll tell you something that don't impress me much, and that is your brother, Michael. Sorry, I don't want to be too critical.
Do
I know
it.
He's your brother.
Go.
And I love the show. But replacing him with Pauline has been a massive, massive upgrade.
Two massives there.
Massive
upgrade. Not replacement, not sub. Upgrade.
Massive thighs.
I was going to say, as long as I have massive body, can't see me though, that's
right. He thinks Red Dwarf's better than The Office.
That's insane.
And it fills me with dread every time you say there's a special guest and, you know, it turns out to be Wifey or Freddy. And I just feel relieved.
I love how he says Freddy.
That's it. We actually...
You're loving that, aren't you, Bob?
Do you want me to show you a picture of him?
Is it Elvis?
Elvis, yeah, Elvis.
Amazon. He sent you a photo of himself.
Oh, he's on WhatsApp, isn't he? So I can
Let's
see.
Guess his age.
Oh.
We'll guess his age.
Oh, I reckon he's young.
We're going to guess his age.
I've seen a picture of him, so I'll probably get it right.
I reckon he's...
Well, we're going to see a picture of him.
I thought you meant after.
Show you the picture.
Guessing his age after the picture.
Oh, okay, do it now then. Just from the voice.
I think he's about 25.
No,
if he was at the 1978 Cup Final, that's 22.
He might just be a fan. So he might. That's like me talking about 1971.
Oh, yeah, I suppose so. Okay. He don't sound that old.
I think he sounds young. I reckon about 25.
25?
I'm going 36.
Ooh.
36, okay, cool.
And you're going to show me a picture and ask
me. Yeah, do you want to see a picture of him?
He's going to have to let us know now. I reckon 28. Is that his own wedding?
I don't know.
Because he looks
nervous. He's standing there. He's standing.
He looks really nervous there.
Yeah.
As if she's about to come down the aisle. Aww. Thank you, Phil.
This ain't good podcasting.
Oh, which of
us? I'll stay with 36.
He's got a powerful chin.
He's going to have to let us know now.
Yeah, you've got to let us know. Amazon Phil, let us know. Let's.
Nice picture.
Yeah, Amazon Phil, I'm sending you a WhatsApp right now. We're live on elimination. Let us know how old you are. We've just had a little guess. So I guessed 74. I didn't. Thanks for listening. A little message.
And he's got a full head of hair. He's young.
He has got, in that picture.
Oh, it could be an old picture.
Yeah, it could be
20 years ago.
Could be an old picture.
I bet he was at the Ipswich game, you know. I bet he was about 73.
Welcome to the party. You've joined our other two listeners, Jane and Trucker Andy.
Does Trucker Andy still listen?
Yeah, of course he does. I mean,
yeah, he'd be put stuff on Facebook.
He's always about.
Because he said he's enjoying the silence.
He's actually been invited to the screening of Dusty, so we might actually meet him. Yeah, let's hope he's not a weirdo. Pauline, have you ever seen Katherine Ryan do stand-up?
No.
I have.
Oh, I did watch some when I, you know, when we first knew.
Well, you've watched it then.
The first round.
But I've not sat and watched it. You couldn't remember. I couldn't relay anything. Then I can't do that with films.
No, that's true.
Only Dirty Dancing and ones like that. Yeah, I don't know her enough, really. But of these people, I don't know enough. I'm just here to make up the number to do a vote.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, we do want one all draws all the time, don't we?
Oh, what's the score in the old quiz?
8-9 to me.
8-9, Dave. Does that, have you got one ready?
I've
got
to do a quick one.
The quiz.
I can equal it up here. I can equal it up. Come on, come on.
Oh, you probably will.
Come on, let's do this.
Oh, I just found one. I forgot I'd done. All right, this is it. It's TV related.
Ooh, I do like a bit of TV.
Now, you know Rolling Stone magazines do their top 100 singers and stuff like that?
Yeah.
They've done the Rolling Stone magazine's top 100 TV shows of all time.
What, all genres?
All genres in the, together.
Jesus!
But... Oh. All you got to do is tell me what show is higher up the list.
Oh, okay, that's okay, yeah,
so
yeah.
I was trying
to think,
what shows are Breaking Bad?
Yeah. Let's get the pennies come out again, not the tuppenny bit.
Is it,
Robert?
Tails.
Never fails. First or second?
I'll go first.
Obviously, all these shows are in the 100. All you got to do is tell me what one is higher. Robert.
Mm-hmm.
Alphabetical order, I'll give you him. Columbo or Star Trek? What is higher up that 100?
Oh, remember, my
Rolling Stone magazine.
I don't think that in the workplace.
Top 100 TV shows of all time.
There's.
I never understood Columbo where you see the murder at the beginning, you know, who'd done it. And he jumped. As soon as he turned up, he knew who'd done it, didn't he? He just jumped
never
on
him. Never watched
it. And he didn't have any question. It's a bit of a. He was good in the role, Peter Falk. But anyway, Columbo or
Falking
Star Trek?
Hell.
Who's higher up that list?
I've got to go Star Trek.
Is that your final answer? Columbo is 45 on the list. Star Trek, according to Rolling Stone magazine, 22nd best show of all time. Pauline.
Yes.
Breaking Bad.
Oh.
Or the X-Files.
Didn't watch that. I know what it is.
X-Files used to scare me.
I never watched X-Files.
I didn't like it. I didn't like it. It was scary.
Breaking Bad.
X-Files is 51st on the list. Breaking Bad is number 2.
Whoa! What's better than that then?
The number 1. Robert.
Yes, Father.
Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
Never watched
or The Office UK.
Oh! Well, out of principle, I've got to go for The Office UK.
Final answer?
Wait. Yeah, definitely. Definitely.
Buffy the Vampire Slayer, 73.
Oh definitely.
The Office UK, 53.
Yeah. I would be higher than that.
Remember,
actually.
My wife loves you, but I don't agree with that in the workplace.
It's an American magazine,
what's going
remember?
On about?
That's in The Office, but it's also Columbo, so it works for both ways. The joke works.
Doesn't.
Well, everyone's right so far. Pauline.
Here we go. Daniel from
Cheers.
Right.
Or where everybody knows
It's you. Always Sunny in Philadelphia.
Oh!
That's that dodgy one that you like with Danny DeVito.
Yeah.
Oh, I've not watched.
That bloke who's in it, who... Dunn Wrexham.
Yeah, Rob McInerney.
He looks like Ben Chilwell, doesn't he? You know the Chelsea left back?
I can't picture
him. All right.
What,
the bloke is Philadelphia or Ben Chilwell?
No, Chilwell, yeah.
Cheers or It's Always Sunny.
Grab anyone. Always Sunny in Philadelphia.
Always Sunny in Philadelphia is number 81.
Oh, well,
I think Cheers would be higher.
Cheers is 8.
Oh, eight. Really? That's high.
It is high.
A lot of careers came out of that one, though. Frasier.
Roberts.
Yes, Father.
South Park or Succession?
What's that?
Oh, I haven't watched Succession yet.
They finished yet, has it?
Oh, is it not?
There's about six episodes down, I think.
Well, don't like that. Is it good?
No, it's too high. Too complicated for you. South Park would be all right.
It's probably right, though.
It can't be South Park, can it? Surely. It's been going longer, but Succession's got this bit of a... that's difficult. I'm going to go South Park just because it's been going longer.
South Park is number 63 on the list.
Oh, that's low.
Succession, number 11.
Wow.
I don't know it.
Wow.
2-1.
Okay.
Good game in hand, though. Ready?
Right, ready.
40 Towers or Fleabag?
Fleabag's really good.
Yeah, but 40 Towers.
Have you seen Fleabag?
No.
Oh, but you should watch it.
I've tried to watch it again. I couldn't.
It's that tall woman.
It's like you've got to have a joke for being disgusting and
I know,
swearing.
It's really
and that's
popular.
It. That's it.
Yeah, but it's not really. I'll
go
about
40
that.
Towers. Go what I've liked.
Yeah. 40 Towers, 68.
Oh!
Really?
Fleabag, 5.
What?
I can't believe it. I'm in shock.
I mean, I did. I really liked
it. I tried it 3 times to watch
it's
that Phoebe program.
Waller something.
The Waller Bridge.
Yeah.
Right, Robert, you lead 2-1.
Let's do this.
Squid Game.
Ooh.
Or Twilight Zone. Welcome to a dimension that doesn't
I found Squid Game really...
Not surly, but he had a great word.
Well, they do it on the Tower of Terror.
Florida. Squid Game or Twilight Zone?
I've got to go Twilight Zone because Squid Game was so disappointing.
The ending was right
there
down,
wasn't
it? Yeah,
crap, yeah.
Twilight Zone, number 12.
Oh, well done.
Squid Game can't be up there.
Squid Game, 95.
Yeah. Squid Game wouldn't be on there at all for me.
Might not be in 5 years' time. But it's new.
Season 2's coming out, isn't it?
The whole world seemed to watch it at once, though, didn't they?
I only watched it because Dave was watching it. He said, yeah, go and give it a go.
Pauline.
Yes.
The Golden Girls.
Right.
Or The Muppet Show. It's time to put on makeup. It's time to do
that. Oh, going the Muppets, surely.
David Fuzzy Bear should have been in there
64. Oh, he's
forgot all about him, didn't we? One of the greatest stand-ups.
I think The Muppet Show.
Golden Girls.
Bang.
Golden Girls, 64.
Oh, no.
Muppet Show.
Oh.
92.
Oh, that's a bit low.
I always remember in Florida they do like a Muppet Show live thing. And they, what's the two
old... Is it from the...
What's the two old fellas?
Yeah, I know what you mean. What is their names?
Warburton and Huffler. Something like that, isn't
Warburton,
it?
Warburton, that's a bread. That's a bread, isn't it?
Is Warburton. It? Well, yeah, it is. Anyway, they came on and went, oh, how come you're here? Oh, I entered a competition. It's like, oh, did you win? He went, no, I lost. Yeah, good. Yeah.
Right, Robert.
Yes.
Oh, no, it's going to be 9-0.
Sesame Street. Or The Simpsons.
Oh, it's got to be Simpsons. Simpsons would be number one, I reckon.
Can you tell me how to get
Sesame
how
Street
to get to The Simpsons?
I found it a bit depressing, Sesame Street.
It reminds me of being at Nan's and her only having 3 channels.
Yeah.
And you watch that in Play Days. You know, like
Sesame Street, 26.
No.
Simpsons, 3.
The Sesame Street where Ricky Gervais is on it, he's talking to Elmo. That is so funny.
Oh, I've not seen that.
It's an outtake before they actually go live. So they're sort of setting up the scene. He goes, right, Elmo, we can't mention certain stuff.
Elmo.
We can't mention certain stuff. Yeah, Ricky, that's right. And he goes, the Holocaust, we can't mention. He mentions all of these are really bad. No, we can't say that. We can't say that.
And now for something completely different. Monty Python's Flying Circus or Sex and the City.
Sex in the City.
Oh. Sex in the City, 78.
Oh, bloody hell.
Monty Python, 33.
Oh.
Robert, yes. The Crown.
Oh.
Never seen it.
Or good. Friends.
Oh.
There's a lot of frog in the front there.
I've got to go Friends because it's just a cult classic.
I love Friends.
The Crown, 88.
Oh, yeah, Friends.
Yeah,
Friends, 49.
I can't wait to hear what number one is.
I thought it'd be Simpsons.
Finally, Pauline.
Yes.
Game of Thrones.
Oh, my God, the whole world did.
Rick and Morty.
Who?
Rick and Morty, one of Bob's faves.
Yeah, I don't watch it anymore.
What's a Rick and Morty?
What's that about? It's an animation.
It's hard when you've never heard of it.
Yeah.
I guess I go Game of Thrones then. Okay. I've never even heard of a Rick and Morty.
Is Game of Thrones number one, do you reckon?
Game of Thrones.
Oh, number one.
31.
Oh.
Rick and Morty, 96.
Oh, that's good. Yeah. Never heard of it.
Yeah. Final score.
Oh, look.
Bob 5, Pauline only
that was
two.
Monday.
Yeah.
Yeah, what was number one?
You should know what's number one. Is it, it can only be one.
I would have said
one.
Breaking Bad.
Well, I thought
no.
Breaking Bad.
Breaking
There's
Bad.
A program that's yeah, not set into a cocked hat. The greatest show of all time, without a shadow of a doubt.
This is the greatest show.
What?
Is it the Generation Game?
Yes.
No.
Britain's Got Talent.
Top Gear.
Come on. How American program.
Oh, Seinfeld.
No.
Oh,
it's not a comedy.
How are we not getting it?
I can't believe you can't get it. It's such
Bear
an
console.
Obvious. No. It's such an obvious number one.
I can't think.
Walking Dead!
No.
Oh.
It's not at all, Bob.
Nine
You've
all
pulled
all
it back.
I have pulled it. I'm well happy. The fact that I can't think of number
happy.
One doesn't bother me.
Look,
nine all.
Black finger now.
From what? 8-1.
It was. About 8-1, wasn't it?
Don't think it was.
I think it was. Definitely was.
What does it begin with, Dave?
Is it MASH or something like that?
No,
Les
Charades.
Oh, right. Two words sounds like...
TV show, Les Miserables.
Is it one word?
It's two words. But the first word's a little word. What I call not a proper word, really.
iRobot.
Violent swearing.
Have I seen it?
You probably wouldn't appreciate it.
No, I probably
it.
Haven't seen it.
You know of it. You know of its existence.
It's not The Sopranos, is it?
It is The Sopranos.
Oh, hey!
Hey, I'm walking
I'm
in!
I'm walking!
Hey! Fantastic.
How did you not get that?
I could watch it.
I've seen it about four times all the way through, and I will watch it again with that shadow of a doubt.
Yeah,
I want to watch I'll feel cheated about Game of Thrones, though, because I really loved Game of Thrones.
Everybody, Vic says exactly
that
the
last
same.
Two
That's
episodes.
That's why I won't watch it, because
it
everyone's
killed
me.
It, stone dead. I can't watch it, because you know where it's heading.
The same as Walking Dead. I'd go back and watch the early ones of them, but
we gave
at
up,
some point
we?
You just stop. Yeah, you have to.
Dave didn't.
No, I went to the end.
I didn't go to the end. In
the bitter end.
Sacrificed about 3 months of my life to watch that.
It was so
it's
good.
When you told me that the whole episode was Carol and
fixing his bike and making soup.
He fixed his bike and she made a cake or something. Yeah. Like.
And she and he's
and he whispering.
He's got petrol to get to Paris now.
Yeah, yeah. That brand new bloody pushchair turned up for him. Where'd that come from? It was ridiculous.
Yeah.
And then Michonne. Yeah,
Shimon.
She said to that kid, your dad's gone, but I'll never leave you. I'll never leave you. Two episodes later, she's on a boat. She's gone, mate. Poor little Judith's on the dock waving her off. I never see her again, apart from my little cameo that lasted 10 seconds at the end.
What did you remind me of when you said Shalom? Who says that, Shalom?
Shalom, yeah.
Oh, hello, Jackie.
Hello, Jackie.
Yeah.
You look nice.
Oh, don't.
Jim. Well, this it's time. And I think... Diary.
I've lost my place, Bob. I can't find where I am.
You're the father of this family. That's your place. It's got a tash still. I like it.
Uh-huh.
I like the tash.
From the acting, that was, wasn't it?
It was.
Ting. Never to be done again. One and done. One and done. Yeah, you could be the next Clint Eastwood, Dave.
Yeah, just imagine. Oh, this would be awful, but it would be a little bit funny, but it'd be awful. If your thing don't take off at all, but they get in touch with Dave,
yeah, and say,
we've got a film role for you,
yeah. And he becomes this big star.
Yeah,
guys, hurry up, bloody hell!
Playing Clint Eastwood's brother.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah, we're going to make a Sopranos UK version.
Yeah, be the Godfather. Yeah. She's written this one.
Oh, is she allowed to write?
Are we talking about wifey or another one?
Bit on the side.
This is very romantic. Didn't see Dave because I had all my washing to do.
Oh.
Priorities.
I went to bed early. He phoned me up twice tonight, had a good chat. I love him and I hope he loves me.
Oh,
did you write underneath? Yes, I do.
No.
No. Diary. So you left your diary at hers?
No, she's put it in that when she I next saw her.
Oh, okay.
Oh, so you hadn't written anything in it? You'd left it a day?
No, I left it that day.
So she filled the gap?
Yeah, I think she does tomorrow as well.
Oh.
Well, we'll have to wait and see what that is.
Yeah.
Pauline, vote, go.
Oh, Tommy Cooper.
Tommy Cooper, but I'm not going to dismiss Katherine Ryan. I think she's a good comedian, whatever you like to call
her. She's a funny lady.
She's a funny person. She is.
She's the one. Yeah, Tommy Cooper all day long. But yeah, again, Katherine Ryan, I really like her.
Sounds
as
like
a kind
Bradley
of,
Walsh then.
As a kind of...
all day long.
Time to face the chaser. Let's see who you're going to be facing.
There we go. She's gone.
Tommy Cooper's through to the next round, and Katherine Ryan is out.
You're out!
If you want to get in touch, Pauline...
Yeah, thank you, Phil. Maybe
yeah, Phil,
day.
Amazon Phil.
I hope you didn't pay him to say that. I'd be gutted.
Pay him today. Oh, yeah, because I made him money. I just throw money at people. So, no, I don't know him. I don't know. But he seems nice. We'll find out how old he is at some point, yeah, no doubt. And Pauline.
Yeah.
I was going to say something there just to end the show, but I can't remember.
I need the toilet bad.
On that note...